Hi, this is Dr. Barganier, and welcome to the Friday Success Series. I am so glad you're here. I am the department chair for the Department of Health Promotion and Wellness. We are in the School of Education at SUNY Oswego. I'm sorry I can't be there today, but I hope you'll enjoy this short clip from me welcoming you to the Success Series. First of all, the Success Series came about from Professor Mary Pagan. It was her idea to really work with all of our students at each class status, freshmen, sophomore, juniors, and seniors, to help do more group advising, to help you be more successful, to reach your goals, to reach grad school, to reach the job market, and to just have a real successful experience while you're here in the Department of Health Promotion and Wellness, majoring in wellness management. So first of all, I want to thank Professor Mary Pagan. This is a great series. This is our third night, and we're glad you're here. So a couple points I want to make to share with you as you move through your journey here at SUNY Oswego in our department. Key points, if you'll take them that way, that to be successful, to stand out from the crowd, to get ahead of your peer group, quite frankly. Number one, every year you have a job. One of your major jobs is to make sure one professor, at least one professor, knows you so well that they can write you a positive letter of recommendation. And that letter of recommendation should really reflect your academic potential and your academic qualifications and what you're capable of doing. That professor does not have to be in the Department of Health Promotion and Wellness, but one of them probably should. So really get to know professors, go to office hours, volunteer, get involved with research assistantships or teaching assistantships or other kind of opportunities that they have for you to get to know them so they know you and can really pick up that phone on your behalf and make a phone call for that job or for that grad school or that grad assistantship that's out there waiting for you when you get out of here. The second tip I have is about studying. I know a lot of you think you know how to study. You did it in high school. You've done it maybe in college, maybe at community college. But at four-year schools like SUNY Oswego, if you really want to get ahead, you need to have grades. You need to have good grades. I don't always agree with how people grade. I don't always agree with the assessment that's used, but the reality is you've got to put in the time. For every 1 hour that you spend in a class, 1 hour, you need to think about spending at least 3 hours outside of class studying. Get out of the, oh, I don't have homework, there's nothing to do mode, like you did in high school. You have homework all the time. It's called reading. Your generation doesn't read. You don't read well enough. You don't read deep enough. You don't read for comprehension. You need to read, 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 read. I can't explain that enough to you. If there's nothing due the next class, you ought to be reading the book, the articles. You ought to highlight it, paraphrase it, rewrite notes, rewrite the chapter in your own words, look up words you don't understand, Google, YouTube, Khan Academy concepts you don't understand, go to office hours, go to see the tutoring center at the Office of Learning Support. Do whatever you need to do to understand the reading. Guaranteed, if you're getting multiple choice tests from professors, and if they have a traditional textbook, more than likely, those test questions come from the textbook. I don't care what their notes say. I mean, I do, but a lot of times those test questions come from the book. You have to read that book several times. Every night, remember, 1 hour in class equals 3 hours of studying outside of class. All right, and that's typically reading. Third point, many of you want to go on to grad school. Some of you are thinking about the allied health professions, such as physical therapy, physician assistant, occupational therapy, med school. Not all of you, and I don't recommend all of you do that. But if you're thinking of that, and really just of any job or any grad school, you need grades, and you need good grades. And I'm talking, you ought to be asking yourself, what can I do to get A's this semester? Every semester, you ought to be shooting for A's, all right? C's don't cut it, folks. C's don't cut it. I don't want mediocrity. Employers don't want mediocrity. Grad schools don't need mediocrity, all right? The people who talk about having a college degree that can't get jobs are the folks in the 2.5 range to probably the 3.0 range. You need to be in 3.3 to 3.5 land, folks, if you want to move ahead in this world. For those of you who aren't near that, start visiting the tutor center, go back to point two, which is study more, get your life in balance. You have to have grades, A's and B's. B's minimal, minimal. Those of you wanting to go into the medical, allied health fields, PT, PA, nursing, You need to make sure, sorry, my notes are falling down. You need to make sure that you have at least A's and B pluses in all your sciences and math. If you're not good in science and math, you might want to rethink going into PT, PA, OT. That's probably not where you're going to go. Now remember, our degree in wellness management prepares you for entry-level positions in worksite health promotion, as wellness directors, as wellness coordinators in universities, in companies, in fitness centers, in community organizations, insurance companies, human resource programs, you name it. There's so many positions that are out there. If you haven't joined my Facebook page, and it's called the SUNY Oswego Department of Health Promotion and Wellness. It's got apples on the front. If you haven't joined my Facebook page, please do so. I post jobs weekly to get an idea of what's out there, what you can do with this degree. Which takes me to sort of, what are you learning in this degree? You're going to get four transferable skills in this major. One, how to do needs assessments on individuals and populations. Needs assessments about health, about their health issues. You'll learn that in HSC 448 with Dr. So. Or other professors. Two, you will learn how to plan programs, health-related programs. Three, you will learn how to implement or put into practice those health-related programs with individuals, groups, or organizations. And four, you will learn how to evaluate, and that's the HSC 488 class. You'll learn how to evaluate health programs that you have developed. Those skills will take you anywhere. They'll take you into physical therapy. They'll take you into worksite wellness. They'll take you into wellness coordinator positions. And with those four transferable skills, we call them our core wellness skills, you will also learn to integrate technology. And we're real excited to have Dr. Yang here and all our other faculty that are learning to integrate technology into almost every class. You will come out knowing how to use technology to motivate, measure, and monitor health behavior change in individuals and populations. And we have a lot of new exciting partnerships starting up in the next year with hospitals and with tech firms. So stay tuned. The niche market that we're going to have here at SUNY Oswego is you're going to come out very technologically literate in the area of health. That's going to make you much more marketable, and that's something that should show up on your resume when you talk to people about what other skills you have. So that's an exciting skill that you have. The last thing I want to leave you with as a wellness management major is I want you to think about how to model a healthy and well lifestyle. And probably for college students, the best thing to do is to sleep. We need you to sleep. We need you to eat well. We need you to exercise. We need you to manage your stress. And we need you to remain substance and alcohol free. Sure, you can have a little fun on the weekends if you're legal, if you're of age, but you are modeling a wellness lifestyle. And if you cannot model that, you might need to get some support and some help to help you make healthy decisions. If we can't make healthy decisions, if we can't model a wellness lifestyle for others, how do we ever expect them to make change? I'm not asking to be perfect. Nobody is. If I can't have a piece of pizza every week, I'm not emotionally well. So you need to be in balance. And we talk a lot about wellness is a process. And it's a process about being in balance. But a lot of college students get really out of whack with alcohol, tobacco, other drugs, and sleep. So get yourself balanced. Work hard. You're here to go to school. You're here to learn. Someone is shelling out about $20,000 a year for you to get educated. That's a pretty hefty cover charge if you're here just to party. We don't want you in the program if you're here just to party, folks. All right? We want you to be a great wellness ambassador for our program. We want you to go out and be a catalyst of change for individuals and organizations to help them become the best they can be emotionally, physically, socially, and spiritually. So this is your journey. You are in control. We need you to work hard, play hard, and have a real positive experience at SUNY Oswego. Network, reach out, make friends, join clubs, get out of your comfort zone, all right? Get to know your faculty. Come to the opportunities that we present. We have get-togethers in our office. We have social networking opportunities. There's so much on this campus. If you're sitting in your dorm room staring at your phone and watching TV, you're not going to get ahead, folks. Join, get involved, and have a great day. Thanks for coming to the Success Series. Stop by and see me soon. Take care. Bye-bye.